A very good morning to my dear students. Let us start our lecture for today. So we were reading chapter 5, cloud computing. So today we have to discuss the topic Google Docs. Okay, so today we'll be doing practical along with the theory. Okay, so we are on page number 70 and let us start from this topic Google Docs. So Google Docs is basically implemented using the concept of cloud computing. Okay, so this is an online office suite which is helping you to create, edit and share three types of documents. So what three types of documents you can create here? First is your document, means like MS Word you are creating, any document in MS Word you are creating, Excel document you are creating using the spreadsheet option, and PPT you are creating, presentation using the PowerPoint. Okay, similarly you can create these three features, three types of document with the help of Google Docs also. Okay, so it will provide you document component of the Google Docs that will be fully featured and rich document, and it will provide you spreadsheet component that will help you to basically manipulate and format the spreadsheets. Means you can add charts there, you can use formulas as you were doing different operations in Excel. Similarly, you will be able to perform here also. Okay, presentation component of Google Docs will allow you to create professional looking presentations. So the main benefit of Google Docs is that you need not download this software in your computer. You just need to have a account on Gmail. There you can use it very easily by logging the through the Gmail account. Okay, so this is the Gmail account. This is my Gmail account. So Gmail account looks like this. Okay, so what are the advantages? Let us go through that also. So first advantage is Google Doc is free for individual user. Okay, then it doesn't need to be installed in your computer. Second benefit, that we can access the applications and all the documents whatever you have stored on your Gmail account. Okay, there is no compatibility issues. Okay, everyone is on the same version. It doesn't mean, sometimes it happens na, we have created a document in Office 2016 and your friend is having Office 2019, so there is a compatibility issue sometime. Okay, so there is no compatibility issue because everyone is using the same version. Okay, because it is online available, so everyone will get the same version every time, right? And the documents are stored online, so there is no, aap ye nahi keh sakte, I forgot to take that document, because it is available online, so you can use it anytime, anywhere. Okay, no need to carry any media, means no need to carry this document in your pen drives or hard disks anywhere, so you are not required to do so. Okay, the data stored online is very much secure and well protected. You are protecting your data with the help of your password. Okay, your password should be strong, then there is no problem otherwise related to your security. If your password you are changing regularly, you are keeping it strong, so your data will be safe and there is no need to carry the data. Okay, I hope these points are clear. So let us start the practical. Firstly, starting the Google documents, how to start it? You need to sign in. I have already signed in. You can see this is my inbox. Okay, and user ID password I have already put here. Clicking on the next button, see, this way you need to log in. Okay, I have already logged in. Fine, now next step is click on the Google app button. Where is the Google app button? Here. Okay, so this is your Google app button. You need to click it on. When you will click it on, you will get several options. Okay, here on scrolling down, you will get this option Docs, and we have to click it on. Okay, when we'll click on this Docs, our Google Docs software will be started up. Okay, so this way it will look like. You can see in the book also. So this is the book, page number 71. You can see it in your book also. So if you want to create a new document, then this blank option is also available here. And if you want to use the previous document that we have already predefined or pre-designed, so they will be available here. Okay, so these are the two predefined documents. Okay, and if I want to create a new, then I need to click on blank. Fine. After this, if I want to create a new, it will look like this. You need to just click on this blank document, and the name of the document by default will be untitled document. So here is the insertion point, you can see here. So you can insert the data whatever you want to. So whatever data you want to insert, you can do it very easily. Okay, so if I'll copy and paste, it will take my data. Okay, so I'm moving back. Why? Because I have just created a document before that only. So I'll be using a predefined document. So this was the document that I have already created for you. Okay, so by default, whatever the data text is starting up with will by default come as the name. Okay, and if you want to rename, then this, see there is an option coming out, rename. Okay, so you can see in the book also. So in file type, if either you can go here, you will get the rename option, or otherwise also when you will click it here, means you will bring your mouse pointer here, you will get a rename option. So either ways you can do to manage the name of the document. Okay, so this was about the artificial intelligence. The first line has taken up and named it. If I want to rename it, then I need to click it. It will allow me to rename. Okay, I just want to make it AI. Okay, so this I want to take it and give it the name AI. Okay, once the document has been renamed, so from here I have shown you the operation of rename also. Then after that, whatever data you want to type the name, and you need to hit enter. I have just done it, these steps. Where this document will get saved, by default will get saved in Google Drive. So where is Google Drive, how you will be able to see it, I will show you. So now this document is ready, and you can see a share button here. So if you want to share this document, means whatever you need to type, it was a predefined, means I have already copy pasted. You can write it as you are writing in MS Word. So after writing, the document is ready, and when this document is ready and you want to share it, then you need to click on this share button. And in this picture also it is showing the same. So if you want to share it, then you need to click on the share. So once you click on the share button, it will show you various options. Two ways are there by which you can share this document, means you need to add the email ID. See, already my account has various email IDs, so I am just clicking it on. So this email ID will be able to get this document. Okay, if I click on send. Okay, otherwise what you can do, if you don't want to send it via email ID, if you don't want to send, then you need to share this link. So this document has been uploaded somewhere on the Google Drive, and it is holding a link along with it. Okay, so first method was to give the email ID to whom you want to send it. Okay, second method is to generate a shareable link. How you can get the shareable link? Get the link here and you can copy it. See, and see, moreover you will have various options to whom with you want to share this link. So you need to click on, everyone should able to see whatever you are sharing. Like I'll be sharing a document with you through this Google Drive, so I'll be clicking on this viewer only, so that every student of mine should be able to see what I have sent in this document. Okay, so if you don't want to allow others to see, then you need to change the option. Okay, so I just want you people to see. Okay, so I just will be clicking on the viewer only. So copy link, this is the link of this document on the Google Drive. So if I'll copy this, so it will show you link copied, and wherever you want to share it, means just paste that this particular link on, like WhatsApp you can share, on email also you can share. Once you have copied the link, it will show you copied the link and done. Okay, this way you can share. How? See, if I want to share it with my friend, so I will go in compose button to compose a new mail, and I will paste this link here by just clicking on. So this is the link of the document that I want to share with my friend. So you need to write the email address of a particular friend. Okay, and then uske baad you need to put the title, it is about the AI, and then you need to send. Okay, now this document has been sent to one of my friend. I hope it is clear to all of you. So if you have done the work like this, you can sign out. Okay, here you will get the option of sign outing. And if you want to see that, this document will automatically get saved on your Google account, Google Drive. Sorry, where is your Google Drive? I told you that you must have a download the Google Drive. So in the same Google Apps option, you will get this Google Drive. So when you will click it on, you will definitely get that particular document saved there. Okay, I'll show you. See, this was a document that we have just created or edited, right? So this is the document that we have created. So it is already there in my Google Drive. Fine. We need to download this Google Drive. As I was already using this Google Drive, so it has not shown me any other option. So once, for the first time, if you are using this Google Drive, it will show you to activate it. Okay, just activate it and there is no problem after that. You will be able to access it very easily. I hope this concept is clear. So in next lecture, beta, I will tell you if you will upload a document from your computer or your laptop, then how you will be able to share it, how you will be able to put that in a folder. You can create your own folders on Google Drive. I'll be sharing that, those things in my next lecture. Till then, you practice it and search out the back exercise related to the topics we have covered in the classroom. Thank you so much, beta. Okay.